Aloha, Congresswoman Saiki. Thank you so much for joining us today. We're very excited to talk with you.
It's my pleasure, Lacey.
I've read a lot about you. You've had numerous accomplishments, but today we really want to find out about the woman behind the title. So can you tell me about where you grew up?
I grew up in Hilo, Hawaii, and went to all of the public schools there, graduated from Hilo High School, where I was a tennis champ. Okay, my father was a real professional tennis player. He had three girls. Three girls. So each of us was Sunny Boy. He wanted a boy. He was, I think, the original feminist, because he always inspired us to do whatever we wanted to do. Never mind that we're girls, you know. After graduating from Hilo High School, then I went to the University of Hawaii. And going from the Big Island to Honolulu, yes, you well know, in those days was a big deal. I mean, you know, you're leaving home, you're going to another island, and you may not come home until Christmas. I had to go out and earn money because I had two other sisters who wanted to go to college. So I told my parents, "Don't worry, I'll go out and find a way to pay my way through college."
How has your time at UH shaped you into the political leader that you are today?
I was very concerned with the manner in which the, shall we say, Department of Education here had set up their courses. I thought they were much too academic, not enough practical experience. I felt that they weren't giving the students enough background and giving them enough credentials to become automatically certified with the Department of Education. And it really sort of irritated me a little bit. I thought that should be changed. But that's when the first scent of politics came into my life.
Going back to your family, I saw a photo of you and your children around a piano. How many children do you have?
Five. I had five children. They were very supportive of my career. I mean, they stood on the highway with a sign, you know, "Please vote for my mom." And I would stand there. So we had five kids, you know, all in a row. My constituents asked me to get them off the highway, however, they were too much of a distraction.
How was that being a mother and also a political candidate?
It's very challenging because you have to schedule. But I never missed the parent-teacher conference.
Going back to UH, what were some of your favorite times here?
We had freedom. Even in those days, we had freedom of thought and freedom of choice. I maintained my contact with the university because it's home for me.
Can you broaden on that? UH is home for you. What do you mean by that?
I served on the Committee on Higher Education for 14 years of my years in the state legislature. I was always very careful that the university not only retained a certain autonomy, that the legislators were not imposing too much of their will on the administration or the activities of the university. I am also one of those that really helped to start the volleyball team with Donis Thompson under Title IX. President Nixon appointed me to the Commission on the Status of Women. We then developed the Equal Rights Amendment to the National Constitution. So working closely with Patsy Mink, then we made sure that the university's sports authorities recognized that women had to have their own locker rooms, they had their own kinds of sports, they had to have financial support, kept a close eye on it to make sure that none of those programs were neglected in any way, shape, or form. So I'm very proud of that. We also created the first, the only sex abuse center at Kapi'olani Hospital. The women were taken to the morgue to be examined by the pathologist there. No sympathy, no follow-up, no therapy, no examination. They were the victims, but they were treated like they had committed a crime. It was the easiest piece of legislation to pass. All I had to do was ask. If your wife were raped, your aunt was raped, your daughter was raped, do you want them to go to the morgue to be examined? No. Sign. Sign this legislation. It passed. I take great pride in that because, you know, I think it was criminal for women to be treated like criminals instead of victims.
Listening to your life journey, it sounds like you have had an amazing life journey thus far. With that being said, do you have any words of advice that you would like to share to the future generations that plan on coming here to the University of Hawaii?
The University of Hawaii is one of the greatest institutions. We have the most excellent personnel. excellent professional people here, it is the place to come, besides the fact that the people of Hawaii are so welcoming. And I'm sure you and your fellow students enjoy it here. Otherwise, they wouldn't be here following through with this program. I would urge everyone to give the University of Hawaii first consideration before they go on to Harvard or Yale or any of these other schools that exist.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.